Hello, welcome to this very special edition of the Pace Report, reporting live here at the 2011 Detroit International Jazz Festival, featuring some of the greatest international jazz and soul artists from all over the world. This weekend's musical cadre is vast, ranging from Chuck Jackson to Mandrill to Jeff Tane Watts to Vijay Iyer to Christian McBride. Tonight's opening festivities kicked off with a bang with the legendary Jeff Tane Watts and the drum club featuring vibraphonist Joe Locke. Congratulations, you are the artist in residence this year and you kicked it off this year. Sure. Tell me about this program.
Oh yeah, we're just trying to create some repertoire for percussion, and I've enlisted my friends, some of the greatest percussionists in the world, and also I can steal from them and watch how they play my music and learn things, so it's really great.
What was it that you wanted to bring visually and also artistically to this year's festival?
It's just about exposure. I think that a lot more people will like jazz based on people taking care of the presentation of it. So, you know, I'm trying to mix jazz with some world music and expose people to some different instruments and things like that. You know, just show them that it's, you know, not just one thing.
What does jazz mean to you?
It means, you know, just life, and it's like a conversation. It's meant to stimulate the heart and make you want to dance, but then enlighten you, you know what I mean? Like catch you with a groove and then take you to places that you haven't been.
You guys from the Dirty Dirty South, New Orleans. What is it that you guys are bringing as far as musically to the festival, and what was it like playing for the Detroiters tonight?
I think what we bring is a mixture of all the different styles of music, which incorporates hip-hop, soul, R&B, jazz, funk, blues, and we give you a little bit of all of that. And it's great to be here with all these people from all different places, and we just want to represent for the world.
What does jazz music mean to you?
Jazz music means no boundaries to me. It means whatever you can think of in your mind and create with your body to then put out as music, whatever that may be.
Thank you. in the Detroit International Jazz Festival. Tell me why this festival is very important.
This festival is important because it's one of the few free jazz festivals. And you can actually see the jazz musician what he does his best. Being himself, showing improvisation, and interacting with the audience.
You know, one of the unique things about Detroit, unlike your hometown of New Orleans, brothers and sisters come out here and support this music.
Mm-hmm. Well, they come out all the time. It's just a different environment in Detroit. Now, in New Orleans, they come out, but they come out for all the styles of music in New Orleans. So when you go to New Orleans, you might not see this, but the band that was playing earlier, when they were moving around, if you notice everybody's sitting around, that doesn't go on in New Orleans. When that band moves around, everybody's following that band. So there's a difference. It's the same, but it's a difference.
What's jazz music mean to you?
Jazz music means good times. It means moving your head, snapping your fingers, shaking your booty if you need to, you know? But also knowing that this is Jeff Watts. This is one of the world's greatest drummers alive now. He comes in the same tradition as Max Roach, Philly Joe Jones, Art Blakey. So he's part of the tradition. All of us as musicians follow some type of tradition. And then we take the path and it goes all different directions.
You've been running this festival for quite a while and it keeps evolving. This is the 32nd year. What was the premise of music and the kind of direction you wanted to go with this year?
I wanted to celebrate this year the fact that our music, jazz, has influenced musicians all over the world. It's not so much about world music as it is about how we have really had that kind of an impact globally. So to invite musicians who love our music from Israel, from Japan, from Brazil, to come here and be a part of our festival seemed like a really nice idea.
You know, one of the things I really like about what you do, every year you have an artist in residence, and this year is the legendary Jeff Tane Watts. Why did you choose him this year?
First of all, I thought it was going to be with the world theme, we bring you the world, that the drum was super important. And so, like, we're opening with the drum club tonight. We're beating the drum. It's a symbol of freedom and democracy. So, in looking at drummers, I think that Jeff is one of the most important drummers out there. He's of the age where he should be doing this kind of thing. He has been wonderful to bring into this community and work with our musicians and our students. And so I just thought it was the right time for Jeff.
One last question. What does jazz music mean to you?
Life. I mean, it really does. I can't imagine not having jazz. I wish that everybody in the world could honestly give themselves time to get inside it, because I think it's a healing, wonderful art form. And I'm very proud that it comes from America.
If you wanna kiss me,
playing back in your hometown.
It's always great to be in Detroit. It's the best festival in the world and the best people in the world. So it's always great to be here.
That'll do it again for another edition of the Pace Report, reporting live at the opening ceremonies here at this year's 2011 Detroit International Jazz Festival here in Detroit, Michigan, here at Campus Marches. I'd like to personally thank the festival organizers as well as the musicians involved, Jeff Tane Watch, Joe Locke, Angelique Kidju, you name it. As always, please visit my website, www.thepacereport.com, for my weekly column as well as my past segments. As well as stay tuned for the next couple of weeks, I'll be having some very special segments produced here at this year's festival.